Okay, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Okay, just wait. Okay, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome back in the general chemistry. Inshallah, today we will start the revision in our general chemistry one, and we are going to solve the past final exams. Inshallah. And you have already the files. I'm going to share you right now. This one. Okay. Okay, okay, who can start? The first question, which one of the following has the element name and symbol incorrectly? Okay. There is a couple of there is options, and each option is a couple of the name and the symbol. Okay, I would suggest you answer me with mine. Okay. So the first one. Okay, which incorrectly? Okay, the key answer here, it's in symbol incorrectly. Okay, you have the bromine. This bromine and its name bromine, so it's right. And Fe, it's iron, okay. Cu, it's a copper, okay. P, potassium. I would say this is the wrong one because potassium, its symbol, it's K. So the answer should be here, D. D. Okay, great. Thanks, Ms. A. Okay, homogeneous mixtures are also known as just. Okay, just reminding you that mixtures are okay more than one component, okay more than one compound. It could be element with compound or two compounds or two elements and so on. And we have two type of solutions: homogeneous one and heterogeneous one. Okay, here. The homogeneous mixtures, it means more than one component. Okay, substance, here it's one. Solids, okay, compounds, it could be the same compounds, okay, it could be the same solid. So the right answer here, it should be A, okay? So homogeneous mixtures are the solutions. Which of the following is an intensive product? Okay, we have already, the property can be divided into intensive and extensive. And intensive, which does not depend on the mass, but extensive, which depends on the amount of the mass, say to say. So energy, okay, it's extensive. Mass, it's extensive. Volume, it's extensive. The right answer here should be temperature. Okay, D, which is intensive property. Okay. Ahsan Shabab, Ahsan Mr. Waleed, Ms. Ahd. Okay. Mr. Hassan, bravo. Great. That's great. Okay. Express the temperature 275 Kelvin in. Okay. Before, okay, just kind of, few advices. You should be quiet and should be, don't be in a hurry, okay? And just write the law in the first place, okay? Kelvin is given by Celsius plus 273 and here 275, so it should be plus 2, should be plus. Okay, to be plus 2. Okay, what is the volume in cubic centimeter of 36.7 pieces of metal with a density of of gram per cubic centimeter. Okay, here it's very simple, just density or rho, could be density the same, could be it's equal to the mass divided by volume. Okay, so I'm giving here the density in gram in centimeter cubic, and I'm asking for the volume with the same units. It's easy, and I'm giving you the weight in gram. So it's very simple. Okay, you need the volume, it should be V equal to mass 7 divided by 695, could be something 6. It should be 5 point something. Which one is for here? 5 point something. Okay, if it's 36 divided by 6, it will be 6, but here it's close to 7, so it should be that one, D. Okay, without any calculator, it's very simple. Okay, it's very, very simple. Okay, great, Mr. Hassan. Also great, Miss Amfan. That's very good. Okay, which one of the following elements in an uncharged state has 36 electrons? Okay, uncharged, it means neutral. It means neutral. Okay, yeah, it means it's not an ion, it's elemental state. So we have the periodic table. Okay, just look to the element with that or with atomic number equal to 36, you will find it, it's a krypton. Okay, it's a krypton. The right answer here is C. Okay, the element has three naturally occurring isotopes. Okay, thanks, Mr. Saeed. Thank you, Ms. Saad. Bravo. Okay, you have three isotopes. You have an element with three isotopes, okay? And I'm asking you the average atomic mass, okay? Average atomic mass or the atomic weight, okay? Or three, it should be just only, I would say, here it's not three, it's a two. Okay? Just you have to multiply this percent divided by 100 with this one, okay, and this one with this one. So I would suggest it will be in between these two values. I would suggest 218, say to say. Okay, here you need to use the calculator because you have this one. It's this one close to that one. Okay, but I would suggest the right one. It will be okay. That one, I would suggest that because the higher percent, 75% with that one. So I would suggest without any calculator, it should be A. Okay, am I right? Okay, great. Okay, thank you so much. Bravo. In the periodic table, the elements are arranged in. How we arrange, the trials for creating the periodic table, we arranged the element in the increasing of the atomic number. So order of increasing the atomic number, the right one should be the choice number A. Great. Thank you, Ms. Ha. Which of the following compounds do not have the same empirical formula? Okay. Just reminding you that the empirical formula, let's give you an example. If I give you, okay, I'm giving here, okay. If you have, for example, the benzene, C6, H6, this is the molecular formula. If you would like to get the empirical formula, you should divide by a common factor. Here it's a 6, so it should be CH. This is the empirical one, the simplest formula, the abbreviated formula. Okay, while the molecular formula shows the actual number and the actual type of the elements. Okay, so I do not have the same do not have the same empirical formula, okay? These two, this couple of compounds, actually, they have the same empirical formula, it's CH, okay? And this one can be divided by two, to end up with this one. This one can divide it by two, and this one can divide it by three. You end up with CH2. But here, the empirical formula is not the same in these two compounds, okay? Because carbon monoxide, the empirical formula is that one, and the carbon dioxide is that one. So the right one, it should be choice number B, okay? Which pair of electrons can form an ionic compound with each other? Which pair of elements can form? Okay, we have two types of compounds, molecular compounds and ionic compound. Ionic compound is formed between metals and the non-metals, and the molecular compound is formed between non-metals. I'm asking here for the ionic. So you should find the answer which contains one of the pair is element, is metal, and the other is non-metal. Calcium and sodium, they are metals. This is wrong. Barium, bromine, this is metal, right? And this is non-metal. I would suggest this one, the right one. Okay, just complete. Oxygen, fluorine are non-metals. Nitrogen, hydrogen are non-metals. So the right answer, it's B. Okay, what is the proper name of FeCl3? Okay, here iron, it's +3. Okay, there are two names. Okay, it could be iron 3 chloride or ferric chloride. Okay, it's impossible to bring both names together. But I can give you, if I give the two names, I should give, for example, A and B or C and D. Okay, so iron 3 chloride should be that one.
Okay? B answer.
Okay, great. To balance equation, this one, it's compression of, I think, the octane, to give you carbon dioxide and the water. Okay, here it's very simple. Okay, just you don't need to balance it from the first plate. You can substitute with this coefficient and see if it's right or not, okay? Or one can balance it in, okay, and choose the right one. It's up to you, okay? So if you have, for example, carbon 8, you need carbon dioxide to be here 8, see to say, and the hydrogen, okay, it's 18. You need here to have at least 9. And now just count the oxygen. Okay? Okay, it's 2 times 8, 16, plus 9. It should be, I would say, 25. Okay? 25, so it's not right. 25 oxygen. Because you have O2 here. And you need to use an integer numbers. Okay? So this one is wrong, D is wrong, and it should be, if you use 2 here, 2, okay, it's 16, you need 16, okay, carbon dioxide. And 18 water, and just count the oxygen. Okay, it will be that one. I would suggest be the right one. Okay, thanks, Ms. Ah. Thanks, Mr. Hassan. Great. You are totally right. So the right one, it's B. So if you don't know to balance it, just you can substitute by these factors and see if it's balanced or not. It's very simple. What is the molecular weight of that one in atomic mass unit? Okay, just it should be 2 times 12 plus, okay, 5 times 1 plus 1 times 14 plus 2 times 16, okay, 32 and 46, 49 and it's 50, so to say, and 73, am I right, or 75? This is one, the right one.
Yes, doctor.
Yes, see. You should use the atomic mass in the periodic table, okay? If you have, for example, some decimals, you should use it, okay? So the right one is that one. What is the mass percent of krypton and compound krypton difluoride, okay? Krypton, it's not 36, it's 84. It's atomic mass divided by 84 plus 2 times fluorine, it's 18, so times 100, okay? 36 and 90, it should 120. 120, it should be something like 70 or 60 something. Okay, without any calculator. It's very simple. If you have the calculator, you can calculate it. Very, very simple. Okay. How many moles of glucose? And I'm giving the molecular formula or chemical formula are there in that one. Okay, here, actually, just the molecular weight, 1 mole, I'm asking how many moles? 1 mole contains the molecular weight, okay? If you get, just calculate its molecular weight, 6 times 1 plus, times 12 plus, okay, plus 1 times 12, okay, it should be 84, okay, plus 6 times 16, 180 كده, I think 180, 180 أو 170 يعني. Okay, and if you put
180 دكتور.
Okay, great, 180, I'm happy. If you have 30.5 gram, so 1 mole, it's 180. If you take 30 gram, will give you X moles. So you should, the number of moles, it will be 30 divided 180, 1 divided by 6. Which 1 divided by 6? It's, you have only the right one in that. Right. Bravo, Ms. Ha. Okay. It's very simple. Okay. Which of the following is not an electrolyte? حد يقدر يعرف, can anybody define the electrolyte? And the non-electrolyte?
Yes.
Just go ahead.
That's something that has positive and negative.
Okay, that's great. I agree with you. But okay, the right definition, bravo, Misa. The right definition, the electrolyte, which is completely ionized in water to plus,
yeah,
to positive cation and negative cation. The non-electrolyte, okay, which does not ionize in water. Okay, I'm asking here for the non-electrolyte. So It doesn't contain, as you mentioned, it should be, I mean, the electrolyte, as you mentioned, which contains the positive and negative cations. This is contains, also this is what contains the same metal cation anion. So the right one, it's argon, C. C, agree with me?
Yes, doctor.
Okay, I'm happy. Which of the following okay, thanks. Which of the following is a weak base? Okay,
that means when they are dissolved in the water, does not dissolve completely.
Okay, which partial ionized in water, you are right. First of all, you can exclude these two. Why are you excluded? Why do you exclude these two? Because they are acids. And I'm asking for a base. So sodium chloride is a strong base. And ammonium hydroxide, it's a weak base. So the right one, it's A. C, you can, if you don't know the answer, just see the options and you can exclude the wrong answers. And you will end up with the right choice, okay? In which chemical species does chlorine have an oxidation number of zero? Okay, oxidation number, as I mentioned, okay, it's a definition, it's a charge on the element. It could be the number of gained electrons or number of lost electrons. Or it could be a charge due to presence of the that element in a compound. I'm asking for the oxidation number for chlorine to be zero, okay? It should be in the elemental state. Here, chlorine, I think it's plus 7 here, and here it's minus 1. Here, okay, here I think plus 5. And the only right one, it's here, it's chlorine. As I mentioned, it's elementary, it should be in its elementary state. Okay? Should be D. Is that clear?
Yes, doctor, clear.
Okay, thank you so much. Ahsan Ms. Hind, Ahsan Ms. Sheikha, okay, Ms. Aad, Ms. Maryam. Ms. Amfal, okay. Mr. Hassan, great. That's very good. Okay. Which one of the following acids can be completely ionized, dissociated in water? Okay. Completely ionized in water, it's a strong acid. Okay. Actually, hydrogen fluoride, it's weak acids. You should keep in your head the strong acids which I told you before, okay, HCl, HNO3, H2SO4, HClO4, ClO4, okay, and actually the only one from this strong acid here, it's sulfuric acid. So this is the strongest acid which completely ionized in water, okay. Okay, 1 mole of nitrogen is reacted to with the hydrogen as follows to form the ammonia gas. Under which condition would it be the limiting reactant? Okay, this question actually needs some effort from you. Okay, you should try each option here. Okay, here you need, okay, it's 1 mole. Of nitrogen requires 3 moles of hydrogen. Okay, I'm asking for one of these options is the limiting reactant. I'm asking when the hydrogen will be the limiting reactant. Okay, here it's hydrogen and here it's nitrogen. Okay. So if you get 5 moles of hydrogen here, okay, you need, okay, less than 2, say to say. Should be 5 divided by 3, should be 1.5 divided by 3, okay. Should be 1.6. I'm giving here if 5 moles of hydrogen is present in the reaction. Would be the limiting. Hydrogen would be the limiting. Okay, I should give you if I give you 5, according to equation, I'm giving you here 1 mole. I'm giving 1 mole of nitrogen, okay? And if you have 5 mole of hydrogen, you need this number of moles. So it will be the nitrogen delimiting reactant in option number A. So it's wrong. If you have 4 mole of hydrogens, okay? If you have 4 mole, 5 divided also by 3, it will be more than 1. So this one also is excluded, okay? If you have 3 moles, it will require exactly 1 mole, okay? There is no limiting reactant in that one. Also, this one excluded. So without calculation, it should be the right one, but we can check to confirm that. If you have 2 moles, okay, you have 1, give you a required 3. If you have 2 here, you need 2 divided by 3. Right? Am I right, Shira?
Doctor?
So? Okay. If you start with 2 moles of hydrogen, okay, the number of moles of nitrogen will be 0.66. So I'm giving here 1 mole, and you require just only this one. So the excess will be from nitrogen. Once nitrogen is the excess, so the hydrogen will be the limiting one. So the right one should be D. Is that clear or not?
T50.
It's not tricky, Miss Fel. No, it's not tricky. It just takes some time.
Doctor?
Mm-hmm.
Can you explain it again? Because I did not understand it.
Okay, I will do. Don't worry. Okay, here I'm telling you that if you start, this is the balanced equation, as you know, that one, 1 mole of nitrogen requires 3 moles of hydrogen. I'm asking you if you started with 1 mole of nitrogen, okay? So you have 1 mole of nitrogen, and I'm giving options for the hydrogen. One of them will make the hydrogen the limiting one. So, 1 requires 3, okay? If I give you, okay, you have one here. If you started with five, how many moles will it require from the nitrogen? So it will be 5 divided by 3. Five divided by 3 will be 1. So X in that one will be 1.6. So if I give you 5, okay, you need 1.6. I'm giving here only 1 of nitrogen. So the limiting one in the first choice will be nitrogen, because you the required amount of moles 1.6, and you have started only, or you are starting with 1 mole. So in this choice, the limiting reactant is nitrogen. Okay, so this is wrong. Okay, we should try the second option. Okay.
Hey, doctor.
If 1 mole requires 3 moles. If you started with 1 mole, okay, if you started with 4 moles plus the 1 mole here, okay, just consider the nitrogen is unknown. X in that one will be 4 divided by 3 to be 1.3. So 4 mole of hydrogen require 1.3 mole. I'm giving only 1 mole. So this one also, at that option, the limiting will be nitrogen. Okay, that's great. Let's try the third one. If you have, okay, 1 mole, and if I give you 3 moles, these 3 moles require X at that one, it will be 1, which I'm giving you. So at this option, there is no limiting. It's the number of moles exactly equivalent to each other. Okay, so this one, it's included. Okay, the last one, if you start with 2 moles, okay, you have 1 mole, require 3 moles. If I give you 2 moles of hydrogen, how many moles you require to that one? Okay, it will be X, it should be 2 divided by 3, it will be X equals to 0.7 mole. Okay, so 2 moles of hydrogen require 0.7. I'm giving here 1 mole. You have 1 mole. Okay. So the excess will be from nitrogen. So the limiting it should be hydrogen. You can do it in other way around. Okay. Have as a following. Okay. You have the balanced equation as a following. 1 mole require 3 mole. And okay, if 1 mole here require X. Okay, X, okay, to be a limiting reactant, the hydrogen, it should be less than 2. So I'm giving here 1 mole. This 1 mole to be equivalent requires 3 moles. So the hydrogen will be limiting when the number of moles is less than 3. Okay, which one here? This is simpler way, simpler than the previous I have done. This 1 mole requires 3. So if I give you 5, the excess will be from hydrogen. If I give you 4, the excess will be from hydrogen. If I give you 3, it will be equivalent. No limiting, no excess. If I give you 2, which is less than 3, so this is the right one. Is that clear now? Hello.
It's clear. Thank you.
أمثال. مس أمثال. Hello. Okay, I can repeat it. I'm going to repeat it again. No problem. It's okay. It's okay. Don't worry. Okay. Okay. Just be with me. Okay, according to the balanced equation, one mole of nitrogen, okay, reacts with 3 moles of hydrogen. Okay, and this is nitrogen. Now you have 1 mole of nitrogen. You have 4 mixtures. Okay, 1 mole of nitrogen plus 5 mole of hydrogen. I'm giving this mixture and I'm asking to know which is the limiting reactant. Okay. So if you start with 1 mole of nitrogen, you need 3 according to the one. I'm giving here 5. So the excess will be from hydrogen. I'm asking the option which has the limiting reactant as hydrogen. So this one is excluded. This one it will take some time. I don't like to do that in that way. Okay. As I mentioned, 1 mole, this is nitrogen, and this is hydrogen. 1 mole requires 3 moles. I'm asking which case the hydrogen will be the limiting. Here I'm giving 1 mole of nitrogen already. Okay, and I'm asking you, I'm giving 5 hydrogen or 4 or 3 or 2. Which one is limiting? If you start with 1 mole of nitrogen according to the balanced one, you require, or it requires 3 moles of hydrogen. Okay, when does the hydrogen be the limiting reactant? امتى يكون الهيدروجين الليمتنج؟ لما يكون عدد المولات اللي مديهولك اقل من 3، لان انا اوريدي مدي لك 1 هنا، يو هاف 1 مور. اوكي؟ انهي اختيار من دول في عدد المولات بتاع الهيدروجين اقل less than 3 اتس دي؟ You got it, or I can repeat in different way. Miss Anfal. Miss Ahdi, you got it, or I do it again?
No, I got it, doctor. Thank you.
Okay. Hint. Miss Hint. Miss Hint. شيخة. Is that clear? Got it or not? Hello. Just answer me. Okay. Ms. Dua. Ms. Dua. Is that clear? Mr. Zaid Ubay. Zaid, did you do the first assessment, the quiz one? Really? Okay. Are you sure? Okay. Okay. Okay, let's see. So let us go to the next question. Which chemical species is reduced in the following reaction? This is oxidation reduction reaction, and I'm asking which chemical species is reduced. Okay, reduction, it's a decreasing of the charge on the metal or compound. Okay, here, if you look to iron here, it's a plus 3 and converted to 0. So the charge is decreased. So the species which is reduced is iron. Okay, is iron. Okay. And you should, okay, I'm fine with directly. What do you mean? Miss Anfer, what do you mean? What did you mean? It's V. Why V? No. No. The same compound, nothing happened. And the carbon monoxide, it's neutral. Okay. Okay, this is compound. Mm-hmm. And if the oxidation number of carbon here and oxidation number of carbon here, the oxygen should be the same. Carbon monoxide. Okay. Carbon here, that one, carbon monoxide, it's plus 2. And here it's plus 4. It's increased. So carbon, which is oxidized. And I'm asking for the species which is reduced. Reduction is the moiety in which, okay, which gain electrons or the charge on it decreases. Okay, so iron in that one, if it's an ionic one, it's Fe plus 3. It gains 3 electrons and converted to iron metal. So the charge changed from 3 to 0. So this is reduction, reduced species. Did you get it? Got it or not? I'm fair? Hello? I'm fair? انا عايز اعرف انتوا ما بتردوش عليا ليه. Why it doesn't clear? Just tell me, write to me. I'm asking which species is reduced. This is reduction. وليد نور, is it clear? Is that clear? Okay, Miss Ahad would see. Okay, that's great. Okay, Miss Anfal, okay, just reminding you that the following. Okay, oxidation, it means, for example, if you have iron plus 2, converted, just lost an electron, and convert it to Fe plus 3 plus 1 electron. Okay, this one, now it's oxidized, oxidation. Okay, but here you have, this is cation here. The charge is plus 3 and convert it to 0. So the charge on the iron decreased from plus 3 to 0. This is reduction. So this is the right one. The next question, which one of the following defines molality? Molality, it's lowercase m equals to number of mole divided by kilogram of solvent. So mole of solid, kilogram of solvent, this is the right one. Okay. mole of solid kilogram of solution, okay, mole of solid per liter of solution, this is molarity. Mole of solvent, liter of solvent, okay, but this is the right one, C, okay, and B is molarity. How many carbon atoms are there in 0.5? This one very simple, okay? This one mole of this one, it contains Avogadro's times 6, okay? Here I'm giving it half a mole. Half a mole, it should be half of Avogadro divided by 6, because each molecule contains 6 carbon atoms, okay? So it should be, if you, okay, Avogadro times 6, okay, divided by 2, it should be 3 times Avogadro. Avogadro is 6 point, this one, this number, when you multiply this one by 3, it should be by 3, 3 times 6, it's 1.8, it's 18, and just write it in that way and increase, okay, this is, it's wrong here, by the way, okay, here I'm giving it 18, I said it's 0.1, this is the right one, okay, if you write it in, like me, it should be 10 to the power 24. Okay, this is right, and also this one is right. Is that clear?
Yes, doctor.
Okay. Which one of the following represent an allowed acceptable set of quantum numbers for an electron in an atom? Okay. We have quantum numbers n, which is principal quantum number, takes the value 1. 2, 3, till it's integers, and orbital quantum number L takes the value 0, 1, plus, blah, 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 till n minus 1, okay? And L, M subscript L magnetic quantum number takes the values, okay, plus L, 0, minus L, and MS, the spin quantum number, there are only two values, plus nos and minus half. Okay, if you have N, L it's 1, it's okay, available, okay, and 0, it's okay for ML, but this one, it's excluded, no 1.1 divided by 3. Okay, if you have N1, L equals 0, it's okay. ML 0, this one acceptable, by the way, B. If you have N5, L equal 4, it's acceptable. While ML cannot be minus 5 here, the minimum value should be minus 4. This is one wrong, okay? And this is one wrong. If N3, L cannot be 3. The maximum value of L here, it should be 2. So this one is also excluded. The right one, B. Is that clear?
Doctor.
I'm happy. I'm so happy. Okay. Which one of the following is forbidden or not acceptable value for the magnetic quantum number? Magnetic quantum number, it's M subscript L, which takes the value from plus L to minus L. Here I'm giving the D subshell, 5D sub, forget about 5, it's N. The most important value, it's D. D, okay, actually, the L quantum number gives you the shape of the orbital. If it's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. If it's 0, it's S orbital, it's P orbital, 2, it's D orbital, 3, F orbital, 4, G orbital, okay? Here, I'm giving D, so the value of L should be 2. So the maximum value of L should be plus 2 till 0 till minus 2. My question here is the forbidden one. So it should be that one, which is greater than 2. Okay, the maximum value should be 2, This is it's acceptable, acceptable, acceptable. The only one, so acceptable, that one. What does the quantum number L represent? Okay, it's orbital quantum number, which give you the shape of the orbital. Just I have written to you that it should be C. Okay, which one, which electronic configuration does not fully follow the Pauli exclusion principle? Can anybody remember what that principle states? What does that principle state? بيقول ايه الكلام Pauli exclusion principle? Can anybody answer me? Okay, just go ahead. لو حد يقدر يجاوبني يعني. Okay, great. Go ahead, Miss. Okay, Miss Anfal, صح. No two electrons in the an atom has the same set of quantum numbers. You are right. Okay, this is the same, right? Also, Miss Hint, agree with you. But actually, it states that no, it's impossible to find two electrons in the same atom has the same set of four quantum numbers. Okay, this is acceptable. Okay, this is, I would suggest.
The answer will be A.
That's right. The answer will be A. This right. This okay. Right. The answer will be A. That's great. What is the full electron configuration of titanium? Scandium, titanium, titanium. اللي هو ايه العنصر الثاني في الترانزيشن ميتال اللي هو 22. Titanium. 22. Okay, we have the periodic table. It's very simple. It's 22, and it's transition metal. The d orbital is subshell is included here. It should be d2. What? Which one has d2? Okay, this one the right. And also this one is right. But I'm asking here the full, not the condensed way. This is the abbreviated way or condensed way. I'm asking for the full electronic configuration. It should be A. Clear?
Clear, doctor. Clear.
Okay. Which is the correct electronic configuration of copper? Copper has some anomalous, has irregularities. Copper, it's okay. Copper, it's a 30. Number breakthrough in 30. 30? No, sir. No, it's 20, sorry, 29. 30 is zinc. Zinc? Yes, I'm all right, zinc. Okay, copper, it's 29. It has some anomalous. Can anybody remember the anomalous of copper? It's like chromium. Chromium should be S1, D5. And the copper should be S1, D10. Okay, where is this one? Let's see that one, the right one. Let's see. Clear?
Clear.
So it's excluded wrong. Okay. This one, it's okay. The regular way, this one, but it is some irregularities for the electronic configuration of copper. Can anybody remember the rule? How do you think of the rule that is about the thing? Which rule?
Yes, doctor.
ايه القاعده اللي هي حد فكرني بالقاعده اللي اوكي طب why this one is right and this one is wrong
if we see the if we see that d it have one electron it's better to give one electron to give that full configuration to give them this solution
D it's totally wrong because the number of electrons is 28. D it's wrong. The right one is C. Also B it could be according to regular electronic configuration it's right, but it's included for some reasons because one electron from S is transferred to D to be completely filled because yeah. The most stable electronic configuration will be when the subshell is half filled Whole completion. حد بيكتب لي الكلام ده؟ It's not once rule. No. مش once rule يا مس أنفال. No. اللي هي قاعدة اللي هي المصادفة على نصف الممتلئة والممتلئة تماما. اوكي اللي هو بيحصل في الكروميوم والكبر. Which one of the following set of orbital can hold a maximum of 14 electrons?
B.
14 electrons. No. Right. It's F orbital. Okay, it should be B. You are right. Which electron configuration does not follow the Hund's rule? Hund's rule? Which one here?
D, doctor?
No, I don't think so.
No, that's mean Paul.
قاعدة هند بتقول إيه الأول؟ قاعدة هند بتقول إيه يا شباب؟
We need to put the electron first. Let's up. نمر كده.
هي مس عادي قولي تاني كده.
دكتور I say we put the electron. The will be put all the electron s up and down and then up and down for 2s and after that 2b up up. And after that, down, down. Do you understand?
I understand, but it's not the right answer you're answering me. أنفال بتقول وليد بيقول سي. هو سي صح. الاختيار الصح يا مستر وليد صح. وهند الكمالي قالت سي صح. ليه؟ واي؟ خمس رول بيقول تملأ المستويات الفرعية فرادة أولا قبل الإزدواج. إيه اللي يخليني أعمل pairing الكلام ده هنا ولسه عندك اثنين vacant؟ أوكي اللي هي دي اللي قدامك دي يا مس عهد دي Pauli exclusion principle. هنا Pauli exclusion يقول الكلام ده خطأ لأن الاثنين دول هيكون لهم نفس الأربعة ست كوانتم نمبر. أوكي إنما قاعدة هند بتملأ المستويات الفرعية فرادة أولا. Should be singly occupied before pairing. So this is the right answer. Okay, does not follow the Hund's rule. أحسن يا مس هند into you and Mr. Wild. You got it, Miss Ad?
Yes, doctor, I got it.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Which set of the element would be expected to have very similar chemical properties? Okay. You should find you have the periodic table would be expected to have a very similar chemical properties. Okay. I would say OSC, this is the same group, the sixth group.
See, doctor.
No, what? B is wrong. Yeah, C, because there are alkali metals and this is alkaline earth is a different group. Okay, the three are in different groups. This is fifth group, sixth group, seventh group. But these are in one group, which is the sixth group. Okay, this also different groups. What is the atomic radii order from largest to smallest? You should start with the largest one. You have Mg and N and B and S. Okay, you should have the periodic table. Where is Mg? It's here. And I'm asking for sodium. These are in the same, by the way, and also this one in phosphorus, selenium, all of them in the same period, by the way. Okay, start with sodium, comes Mg, and comes selenium, and comes phosphorus. If you move from okay, left to right, the atomic radius decreases, okay? So the greatest one should be sodium, then magnesium, then Si, and so on. Where is sodium? The only one it's here. It's very simple. Do you agree with me?
Doctor.
Okay, which one of the following atom has the highest first ionization energy? Okay, ionization energy is the ejection of, okay, it's the energy required to remove the first or the most, the outermost electron, nitrogen and oxygen in the same period, and lithium and the boron. Lithium, all of them are in the same period, by the way. Okay, it's lithium and then boron and then nitrogen and then oxygen. The ionization energy increases from left to right. So the highest one should be oxygen. Okay, you agree with me?
Yes, doctor.
ما في حد بيكتب لي حاجة يا شباب. مساعد بتكتب لسه لا. لسه لا يا مس أنفال تماما. لسه ده باي ذا واي ده ميتال. هو أصلا بيميل إن هو يفقد إلكترونات. أوكي؟ فسهل عليه يفقد مش محتاج أي طاقة خالص، هو يفقدها كده بالود يعني بالحب زي ما بيقولوا يعني. تمام؟ لأن هو ميتال، والميتال ميتال تند تو لوس الكترون ايزيلي، سو اتس ايونيزيشن انرجي اتس سمول. اوكي، if you go from left to right, the right, the atomic radius increases in this direction. Once the atomic radius decreases, okay, so the attraction of the outermost electron with the nucleus increases, so you need more energy to remove the outermost electron. So the right answer should be oxygen. Okay, I'm going to stop with the 35, which one of the following ions had the largest radius? Largest radius, okay. You have the periodic table. You have Mg, and then the calcium down it. If you move from up to down, the atomic radius increases, and from left to right, it decreases. So this one should be the greatest one. But here, if I'm talking about the metal, without it's not, I mean it's not anion or cation. But here, but I'm giving you the ions and the cations. So this bromine and chlorine, the size increases. Which one of the following ions had the largest radius? Okay, this is decreases, and this is also decreases. Which one? And the chlorine, bromine, the right one, it should be B. Somebody write B? Right. أحسن يا مس هند. دكتور I believe question 21 was B. اوكي هرجع له. حاضر يا مس. خلاص انا كده واقف عند كام؟ 35. خليكم فاكرين، خليك فاكر يا عهد. فين 21 بقى يا مس انفال؟ No, it cannot be. How comes it to be? Can you talk to me, Miss Anfal? ما تفتح المايك كده وتكلميني. أنفال؟ Okay, just write. Type practice. Type as you can. It cannot be V at all. It's impossible. It's totally wrong answer. I'm asking here that which chemical species is reduced. حصل لها reduction. Reduction لما الشحنة فوق العنصر تقل. اوكي ده تفاعل اكسده واختزال يا مس انفال. لازم يكون عندك عنصر حصل له اكسده وعنصر حصل له اختزال. الاكسجين ده لا اكسد ولا زي ما هو، هنا نقص 2 وهنا نقص 2. يبقى انت عندك كربون وحديد. شوف الكربون هنا. اوكي لما تاخد السي او اتحول لسي او 2. الاكسجين ماينس 2. يبقى الكربون هنا كام؟ موجب 2. الاكسجين هنا ماينس 2 في 2 يبقى ناقص 4. يبقى الكربون هنا المفروض موجب 4. يبقى الكربون اتحول من موجب 2 لموجب 4. دي اكسده. اوكسيديشن، فقد في الالكترونات. اما تيجي تشوف الحديد هنا المركب هو ما حصلوش اي حاجه. لا ريدكشن ولا اوكسيديشن، نفس المركب. انما لما تيجي تشوف بقى الحديد هنا والحديد هنا. الحديد في الاف هنا هوتي 3 في 2 بكام؟ بناقص 6. ناقص 6 تقسمهم على 2 يديك الاير هنا موجب 3. طب الاف اي ميتال لوحديه عليه 0. يبقى تحول من موجب 3 تو 0. يبقى الشحنه قلت. يبقى اوكي يبقى هنا اكتسب الكترونات 3 الكترونز، يبقى ده اللي حصل له ريدكشن. نو الكربون اوكسيديشن ست بتاعته مستحيل تكون 3. الكربون اوكي ممكن تكون 3 مفيش مشكله، بس انا بقول لك هو 2 و4 في المركب اللي قدامك. المعروف عن الكربون ان هو كام؟ موجة 4 على طول. اوكي زي انت ما بتقول اجري وذ يو 4. انما هنا في المركبات عندك ايه؟ عندك كربون مونوكسيد اتحول لكربون دايوكسيد. بغض النظر عن الايه لو تلاقي بالارقام اللي ماليش دعوه مش هتفرق معايا نمبر اوف مولز. انما هنا المركب ده نيوترال يا مس انفال. وكل اللي عايز يغادر يغادر يا شباب، انا هاخد الغياب من الحضور من عندي يعني مش هنادي النهارده. ده مركب نيوترال يا مس انفال. اوكي يبقى المفروض مجموع الشحنات عليه بتساوي صفر. الاكسجين معروف دايما ماينس 2. يبقى الكبر سوري يبقى الكربون علشان يبقى متعادل لازم يكون موجب 2. هنا الاكسجين ماينس 2 يبقى هنا ماينس 4. عشان يبقى متعادل يبقى لازم الكربون موجب 4. معايا يا انفال؟ يو غات ات؟ Okay, great. Thank you so much. وإن شاء الله أشوفكم بإذن الله المرة اللي جاية. I'm going to continue from 36 questions. جزاكم الله خيراً.